Hey guys, Kristen here. This is part 7 of the Mastering Your Emotions series, where I talk about emotional situations that we all encounter while living with severe chronic fatigue. Today's topic is not knowing who you are anymore. So for a lot of us, when we were ill, we defined ourselves a certain way. We defined ourselves by the things we did and the things that we cared about. For example, I used to define myself as a consultant and a CrossFitter and an entrepreneur. And when I became severely ill, I wasn't able to do any of those things anymore. And I was left not knowing who I was. And it's a really weird place to be, because even though maybe you still have some of these identities, maybe you're still a mother, for example, while you're ill, but you're not able to be the mother that you used to be able to be. Meaning, you still have that role of mother, but it doesn't look the way that you want it to look anymore. And this happens because we humans have this tendency to define who we are by the things that we do. You're a carpenter, you're a banker, you're a sister. And there are responsibilities and actions tied to those identities. So what happens when you can't perform those actions anymore? Do you really lose that identity? Sometimes you do, and not always. But what does that mean about our identities if they're so fluid? It means that we shouldn't be identifying ourselves by the things that we do. Because when we're on our worst, we're in our worst energy days, and we're unable to get out of bed, and we're hardly able to think clearly, we still are. There is still a you inside that is living and existing and experiencing life. And this is subtle, but the point I want to get across here is that there is a self inside of you. When you're sleeping and unconscious, when you're on your worst of energy days in bed, and also your future self who is out there walking around and having a great life. It's all the same you, but you're doing different things. So instead of defining ourselves by what we're doing, I want you to learn to identify with that you-ness that's inside. The you-ness that exists, the you-ness that thinks and believes and has emotions as who you are. And that you-ness can be doing anything. It can be doing nothing. It can change what it's doing. But the you-ness inside is who you are. And once you begin identifying with the you-ness inside, it's very freeing, especially when you're still living with severe chronic fatigue. And if you can nail this one on identity while you're still ill, it is gonna put you in a really great place while you're recovering and getting your life back. Because it's gonna open you up to way more possibilities about how you choose to spend your time, the things that you choose to do and choose not to do once you have those opportunities again. Because you aren't limited by this identity of doing things. You're open to the identity of discovering more of yourself. All right, so this is another one of those topics that's really big and probably deserves its own book someday. But if this brings up questions for you, or you're not clear on something I'm trying to say, like, let's get a conversation going in the comments. I love, love, love getting comments. I reply to them as soon as I possibly can. I'm like basically like monitoring my email for new comments. So let's talk more about this identity thing and what it means to identify with your you-ness instead of by the things that you're doing and the results that people get out of doing that while they're recovering from severe chronic fatigue. All right, let's get some great conversations going in the comments. If you found this a useful tip on how to live with severe chronic fatigue, then you can subscribe to my YouTube channel. I post here almost daily. Sending you love and health, I'm Kristen.